What is up, Broncos fans? The Denver Broncos show back here again to do another video. In this video, I'll be recapping the Denver Broncos 31-24 win over the Indianapolis Colts in week one of the 2014 NFL regular season. Of course, it was on Sunday Night Football, nationally televised game. Great win for us. Great way to start off the season. Moving to 1-0, beating a great opponent, great team in the Indianapolis Colts. Definitely a game we could have played better in. Definitely was a game that was kind of a tale of two halves. But we played well. We got the win. We moved to 1-0. As I mentioned, this really was a game that was kind of a tale of two halves. Our first half, we played phenomenally well. We dominated the Colts in that first half, outscoring them 24-7. Really jumped on them early, and really just looked like the much better team. And the first half really was kind of how I thought the majority of this game was going to play out. And we just did a great job offensively and defensively, really hitting on all cylinders. We did a great job of forcing turnovers defensively in that first half, and our passing game was on point. I thought our offensive line did a great job protecting Peyton Manning throughout this game. We only gave up one sack to the Colts defense here in this game, which is something obviously we struggled with against the Colts last season. Robert Mathis, of course, was out of this game, so it made it easier for our offensive line to protect Peyton Manning. Manning finished off with a great game. It was 22-36 for 269 yards, had three touchdowns, no interceptions, did a great job making smart throws throughout the game, not turning the ball over. You love seeing that. And him and Julius Thomas did a great job of taking advantage of the huge mismatch that we had with Julius Thomas here against the Colts defense. And that's something I've mentioned in my preview, that I thought the Colts really didn't have anyone to contain or cover or that could stay with Julius Thomas at the linebacker or safety positions. And I thought their personnel defensively was going to have a big problem containing Julius Thomas. And I thought that was a big mismatch the Broncos could utilize in this game. And you saw them go to that multiple times there in the first half. Thomas had a huge game, finished with 7 catches, 104 yards, 3 touchdowns, all of which came in the first half. And we did a great job of mixing and matching where we lined him up throughout this game, did a good job of putting him out in space. And his quickness, his size, his athleticism, it was just all too much for the Colts secondary and their defense to handle in this game. Did a great job of our offensive line protecting Peyton Manning there in the first half and throughout this game, giving him time to make those throws, and then just a even more brilliant job by Peyton Manning to utilize that mismatch he had with Julius Thomas here against the Colts defense and go to that consistently throughout the first half. And even Emmanuel Sanders played well in this game. He had 6 catches for 77 yards, also had 1 carry for 11 yards. Really showed what his speed and playmaking ability can bring to this offense, but primarily his speed can kind of line up in that joker position for us, take the top off the defense, make some plays down the field, but also as a guy that we can run some reverses with, and again, kind of be that joker position for us on the offensive side of the ball. We are kind of Percy Harvin, if you will, and he played fantastic as well in this game, and just a great job in the first half, primarily by the offense, of just really taking it to the Colts defense and pushing the ball vertically down the field here. Defensively, we also played phenomenal, not only in the first half, but throughout this game. Did a great job on third down here against the Colts. The Colts went 4-13 on their third down conversions in this game. You love seeing that. Did a great job defensively of getting off the field, winning that battle on third downs, getting the ball back to Peyton Manning. That's what we got to do to win. Got to be successful on third downs, winning that battle on both sides of the ball, but especially on the defensive side of the ball. And to do it against offense, you know, that's headed by Andrew Luck and has the personnel that they have, it was impressive to watch. To hold that offense to only 4-13 on third down conversions is pretty impressive, and did a great job of getting off the field there on third downs. I thought our pass rush was phenomenal all night. We had 3 sacks here on Andrew Luck, hit him 6 times in this game. Did a great job of consistently pressuring him, not really giving him time to read the field or make throws, or never really had a clean pocket to throw in. That's something we struggled with last year, of course, in that game against Colts. We really didn't do a good job of pressuring Andrew Luck, and didn't do a good job of when we made him run and get out of the pocket, of getting in his face and kind of limiting his opportunities to get out of the pocket and get to the edge. I thought we did a great job, again, of kind of collapsing the pocket here in this game and then sealing the edges. He really had nowhere to go, and DeMarcus Ware also was a big reason for that. Finished with 1.5 sacks here against the Colts. Had a huge sack there in the third quarter that forced the Colts to kick a field goal. It was in the red zone. That was big for us. And our red zone defense throughout this game was huge. The Colts went 2-4 in the red zone, primarily in that second half. We did a great job of containing them in the red zone. We had a big fourth and goal stand there in that third quarter. Brandon Marshall did a great job of reading the QB sneak, locking up Andrew Luck, and then, you know, you saw 4 or 5 other Denver Broncos swarm to the ball, swarm to Luck, stop them on fourth and goal. Of course, I mentioned the DeMarcus Ware sack on third and goal to force them to kick a field goal. Won the turnover battle as well. You like seeing that. The Colts had two turnovers in this game, both of which were interceptions by Raheem Moore. Aqib Talib did a great job of being physical in coverage all night, kind of showing what he's going to bring to the secondary with his physicality. Had a big old tip pass there in the first half that led to one of Raheem Moore's interceptions. And again, offensively, did a great job of not turning the ball over. Only had, you know, had zero turnovers. You love seeing that. Winning the turnover battle was crucial for us. We also did a great job of stopping the run. The Colts only had 54 rushing yards in this game. You love seeing that. Did a great job of containing Trent Richardson. And that all starts with Terrence Knighton up front, the big pot roast defensive tackle, clogging the middle up. And really not allowing the Colts running backs to have any lanes or gaps to run through. Also, Marvin Austin was crucial for that. Did a great job, our defensive line here, of clogging up the Colts running lanes and stuffing their run game here. And again, like I said, our second half defense was phenomenal. The Colts had seven drives there in the second half, and this is what they did. They went turnover on downs, kicked a field goal, punted, scored a touchdown. Then we got an interception, of course, by Raheem Moore. They scored another touchdown, and then they turned the ball over again on down. So you love what we did in the second half. Our defense really did a great job of kind of picking up our offense there in that second half. Brandon Marshall's tackle on the QB sneak of luck. DeMarcus Ware's sack on third and goal. Quentin Carter's touchdown-saving tackle. Bradley Roby's deflected pass there to win us the game on Reggie Wayne. I mean, defensively just did a great job of making plays, bottom line, and sealing the game there in the second half. Was really proud of our defense. It was a great performance by our defense. Jack Del Rio should be proud, and all the guys on defense should be proud. This was a heck of a way to start off the season for the Broncos, especially on the defensive side of the ball. Brandon Marshall, again, making his first career start in for Dane Trevathan, was all over the place here in this game. Had 10 tackles, 2 tackles for loss, had a pass deflection, was all over the place, did a great job in coverage, and again, was huge on the goal line stand on the QB sneak stuff, and Andrew Luck on fourth and goal to get us the ball back. That was a huge play by Brandon Marshall. Great job by him of reading that play and bringing Andrew Luck down, who definitely isn't a small quarterback by any means. Bradley Roby, already talked about what he did in this game, had 7 tackles, 3 pass deflections, had the big pass deflection to seal the game for us on Reggie Wayne in the fourth quarter. Played pretty physical all game, made some nice tackles, and again, kind of showed what his physicality can bring to this team. Quentin Carter, a guy that struggled with injuries the past couple seasons, played really well in this game as well, had 7 tackles, made a touchdown saving tackle there in the second half for us, really played well at the safety spot. And then Nate Irving also had a phenomenal game. 5 tackles for Nate, finishes with 2 tackles for loss, and of course had a sack there on Andrew Luck in the second half. Really played well and did a great job of really stuffing the run game. It really was him, Terrence Knight, and Marvin Austin that headed our run defense here in this game. And this was a game that was a tale of two halves, and our second half execution was terrible, and it primarily was our offense that really kind of sputtered there in the second half. We were outscored by the Colts 17-7 there in the second half. You don't like seeing that. Again, luckily for us, our defense executed and played really well to help us kind of stave off the Colts and get the W here. And if it wasn't for our defense, we probably wouldn't have won this game. But the second half execution really has got to get better. And you can't expect to beat teams going forward throughout the regular season, or definitely win the playoffs if you're going to play so inconsistently, especially on the offensive side of the ball. This is an offense where it's not acceptable for us to score 24 points in the first half and only 7 in the second half. That just should never happen. And it just really was poor execution on our offense's part there in that second half. Allowed the Colts to get back in the game. A lot of our drives sputtered there in the second half. We had 6 drives in the second half, and we went punt, 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 touchdown, punt, punt. So in 6 drives that you had in the second half, you punted on 5 of those against this Colts defense. That just can't happen. And again, the second half execution by the Broncos offense was piss poor, and it's gotta get better. You can't have 5 out of 6 of your drives in the second half be punts. Not with Peyton Manning as your quarterback. Not with the personnel that we have offensively. That should never happen. So we struggled running the ball throughout this game. We did have 102 yards, which you like seeing, but we did only average 3.2 yards per carry here in this game against the Colts defense. So you'd like to see next week going against Kansas City, the offensive line, which was great in the pass protection, played better in the run blocking game, and also our pass protection was a little shaky there in the second half. They started getting to Peyton a little more. That's something you got to be consistent for four quarters offensively, and that's obviously going to be I think the big thing going into to week two against the Chiefs, especially for the Broncos offense, is being consistent for four quarters. Because as I mentioned, our defense played phenomenally in this game, and they were the main reason we won this game. But we did give up 408 total yards of offense to the Colts here in this game. You don't like seeing that. Again, the defense was on the field a lot in the second half because the offense couldn't, you know, put a drive together and was playing so poorly there in the second half. The execution was horrible on the offensive end, but you still don't like seeing your defense give up 408 total yards of offense. Colts did a great job of moving the ball there down the field against us in the second half. They brought Ahmad Bradshaw in, and he was kind of like that spark their offensive needed. Andrew Luck had 370 yards passing against us. He had a rushing touchdown there in the first half, and granted, he had 370 yards of passing on 53 attempts. That's definitely he had quite a bit of an opportunity to throw for that many yards, but still, we got to be better, a little bit better in coverage, and just a little bit better defensively of giving up the big plays. You don't like seeing us give up 408 total yards. The Colts did have four receivers in this game with five plus catches, so we'd like to see the coverage improve a little bit going into next week. But defensively, not really much to you know, criticize or blame here. They were on the field a heck of a lot there in the second half. And I would like to see us get Demaryius Thomas a little more involved next week. He was targeted a lot in this game, but he did only have four catches for 48 yards. The Colts did a good job of limiting him in this game. They did great. I think Greg Taller was on him here in this game, the Colts defensive back. He got called for a couple pass interference flags and a couple legal contact flags on Demaryius Thomas. So they did a good job of being physical with DT, but I would definitely like to see going into week two the Broncos look to get DT more involved, and would like to see a little more urgency out of DT to get involved in the game. I don't like seeing him only have four catches for 48 yards against a pretty poor Colts secondary. So that's my recap, guys. Thank you for watching. Leave me a comment below, whether you're a Broncos fan, a Colts fan, NFL fan. Just leave me your opinion about this game here between the Broncos and Colts, week one of the NFL. What stuck out to you? What stuck out to you from this game? What did you think the Broncos did good? What did you think the Broncos do bad? Same if you're a Colts fan. What did you like that the Colts did? What did you think they did poorly in this game? Just leave me a comment below. Always love hearing from you guys. Always love interacting with fellow NFL fans, fellow Bronco fans. Again, great way for the Broncos to start off the season. 1-0, beat the Colts 31-24. See you guys sometime this week for a preview for the Kansas City game. And as always, guys, go Broncos. 1-0. Let's keep it rolling.